Are you a good camping neighbor? Stay tuned to find out.
Hi, thanks for joining us today. So, you know, this past year, there has been a huge increase of people out camping. You know, with COVID-19, vacation plans have been canceled and destinations have been closed. So a lot of people out there have discovered something that we already know, that camping is a great vacation alternative. So with so many new campers out there though, we thought today would be a great time just to go over some, you know, basic camping etiquette. Something to ask yourself, are you a good camping neighbor?
Hi, if we haven't met yet, this is Holly, I'm John, we are Let's Go Now Adventures. In our YouTube channel is about all things camping. You know, whether you're into tent camping or RV camping, our videos are there to help you have a better camping experience. You know, campers are some of the best people I've ever been around. They're the most friendly and the most kind. But every once in a while, you have a camping neighbor, you know the one, that what they do makes your camping experience less than wonderful. Now, you know, I don't really think that they're bad people, I just think they don't know. You know, if you've done much camping at all, you'll recognize the name KOA. You know, they've probably been involved with more camping nights than any other organization. You know what? They've put together the definitive camping etiquette guide. And today we're going to go through the 10 items on that guide to see how we stack up as a good camping neighbor. So let's get started. Holly, what's number one?
Okay, so all of these are going to be kind of short and sweet. They're kind of no-brainers, but number one would be observe quiet hours.
You know, if you're camping, whether in a campground or boondocking, it's generally accepted that somewhere around 9 or 10 o'clock at night until about 7 or 8 in the morning is considered quiet hours.
Number two would be conscious of your outdoor lights.
Your lights, when you're camping, could be shining in somebody else's tent window or RV window. The other thing too is that a lot of people go camping to see the night sky, and if your lights are on, they're blocking out that view.
Number three is don't cut through another person's campsite.
For a couple of days, while that person's reserved that campsite or set up camp, that is their space. Yeah. They've got their gear out, their kids are playing in that area, so don't walk through those. Please go around their campsites because you're invading that space.
Yeah, it feels intrusive, doesn't it?
It does.
Yeah. Okay, number four, kind of a no-brainer, but keep your pet on a leash.
It is a no-brainer, but there's one other thing with pets, especially dogs. If your dog isn't socialized to be around other dogs or people, they may not be ready to go camping yet.
And pick up after your pet. So number five would be don't leave your food out.
At night, if you leave your garbage out, little critters, sometimes even big critters, are attracted to that. Now, if we invite those animals like raccoons and skunks in to go through your garbage at night, they'll be coming back for another meal when somebody else is camping there. If you leave your garbage out, it can also attract larger animals like a bear. And so we don't want to set up a pattern of bringing bears in for a quick snack in a campground.
Okay. Number six is be conscious if you're arriving late.
It's gonna happen to all of us.
It does.
We're gonna arrive at a campsite late, and the campers that are there understand that it does happen, but just be aware that you can be as quiet as possible. As you arrive, drive slow, and remember, there are other people probably sleeping.
So number seven is, sounds kind of funny, but make sure you're in control of your children.
And your pets.
Yeah.
And the reason is that you've probably heard this if you've been camping before, where someone's yelling at their dog or their child constantly throughout the day.
It's a little obnoxious. So number eight is make sure you put your fires out.
I did a video on fire safety, and you'll see the link. It's just right up here. But if you're gonna use a fire, make sure that you're aware that you can, that there are no fire restrictions in place. If there are no fire restrictions and you can have a campfire, when you're finished, please take a moment to make sure that that fire is out.
Number nine is be conscious of your generator.
You know, sometimes these devices are critical in order to continue to camp, but if you have a generator, please be aware that there are generator hours at many campgrounds, And if you don't need your generator, turn it off.
Number 10 is leave your campsite better than when you found it.
Please follow Let's Go Now Adventures. And when you go into a campsite, if someone before you has left their trash, been inconsiderate enough to leave behind garbage, please pick theirs up along with taking all of your stuff out when you leave. The reason is if everybody can do this, we can keep those campgrounds and those campsites and that Forest Service land open for camping for years to come. So what we're doing, if you can join us, is we're paying it forward by leaving no trace.
Sounds great. And thanks, KOA, for your 10 camping etiquette tips.
You know, there's really no need to memorize all of those items that we just presented to you. Really, all you need to do is put yourself in your neighbor's shoes and then make a decision, is what I'm doing going to negatively affect my neighbor? If it does, then you know what to do.
So if you're a new camper, hopefully we've given you a few things to kind of think about. And of course, if you're an advanced camper, maybe just a little refresher on things to be aware of. Hey, if you got some value out of this video, give us a big thumbs up. We would also love to have you subscribe to our channel. Hey, thank you so much for joining us today, and we'll see you on the next adventure. Bye-bye.
So here we go. What's number one, Holly?
Number one is to observe quiet hours.
Now,